It has been a long time coming, and it is finally here. Quad HD live switching and 5-channel recording with the ATOMOS Sumo 19 and the Shogun 7. Want to learn more about how it all works? Let's go. So here we are, and we've got these new firmware updates. So if you're on 9.2 on the Sumo 19 or later, or 10.4 on the Shogun 7 or later, then you will have this functionality on your monitor recorders. Now, I'm the blue collar guy. I'm the diner guy. I'm not the Vegas nightclub guy. So the way I do videos is I just dig into the educational side of this and help you figure out how you're going to use these tools in your production. And that's exactly what we're going to do right now. So let's go ahead and jump into here and take a look at our sources. And we have four of them. And what I wanted to do was set up something that I felt was really typical to a live multicam shoot, a studio shoot. And so what I have is I have four different sources. You don't have to have four. You can have two, three, or four sources. What we have right here is we have a camera up here in the top left, and we're also pushing out a program feed. You can do that over HDMI or SDI. We've got our B camera right here, which is our four up right now because that's what it's pointed at for this user interface. We've got our overhead camera, and we also have our laptop push, which is basically a keynote presentation, could be a PowerPoint presentation. So a couple of things. First camera over there is a C200. That is SDI out directly into SDI 1 on the Sumo 19 or on the Shogun 7. And that's really important. Something has to be plugged into SDI 1 for this all to work. That is also going to be what goes into SDI 1, your master clock. Because what you're also getting with all of this functionality on these two devices is essentially Genlock without having to have Genlock ports on your camera systems. B camera and C camera here, B obviously getting tabletop shots and C being this overhead shot right here, those are C100 Mark I. So they are not SDI cameras. We have to go SDI in to these two devices to get this all to work. How do we do that? We do it with this, which is the Connect Convert. It is very simply an HDMI to SDI converter. So we do have to make sure that all of our cameras and our sources match each other. When that feed's coming into these cameras here, and I'll just go ahead into A and just show you this, we're actually doing a 2-2 pull down. Because we've got a signal that's coming in that's essentially 1080i at 59.94, and we are converting it to 1080p 29.97 using the Sumo 19. I can do the same thing with the Shogun 7. So my fourth source is this over here, which is the laptop computer, and this is very typical to be pushing a keynote or a PowerPoint presentation. And what we need to do is make sure that what's coming into either the Sumo 19 or the Shogun 7 matches with those other three sources. So what we're doing to handle that is this Connect Convert Scale. So yes, it is doing something similar to the Connect Convert where it's converting my HDMI out from the laptop to SDI to get into one of these inputs. But it's also making sure that my signal that is now coming into this or this device is matching in terms of the input. So if I go over here, we have four signals that are coming in that are 1080i 59.94, and then with the 2-2 pull down, 1080p 29.97. So those are those settings. Let me go ahead and step out of there. And then when we go up here on the Sumo 19, again, it's a little bit different on the Shogun 7, and we take a look at our input sources, it is going to allow us to change where our input source is. Now, if I go over here to SDI 1, and I go ahead and press OK, I'm now just looking at a single source when it reboots, which is going to be my A camera. It's a little bit Inception-y. That's what we've got here. I'll go back up over here. Here's the real Inception-y, which is our B camera. And we'll take a look at that. That's fun. And then this is the key to the castle here, which is SDI multi-stream on both of these devices. And when I go ahead and I press OK here, as long as all the sources that are coming in, as I showed you, match with each other, then we're going to be able to see these sources here. Now that could be, again, two, three, or four sources in terms of video. What happens if one of your sources doesn't match? Well, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the Connect Convert scale here and we're gonna change its out. So let's just go ahead and do that and see what happens here up on the screen. We're gonna get this little warning. For ISO mode requires all connected video inputs to be of the same frame rate and resolution, blah-de-dee-blah-de-dee-blah. And you'll see here that 4 is not available. We're done. We can't do anything here. So what we have to do is we have to switch that back, and it's gonna take a minute or so for it to basically realize that the signal that's coming in is a matching signal. And then as soon as it does that, we'll be able to then take advantage of this feature again. There it is. And now we can see all of our different sources. So depending on your setup and how you're doing things, let's say you're doing all cameras and they all match, then it's easy peasy because you just go ahead and set all of your cameras to the same resolution, to the same frame rate, up to 1080i or 1080p, 60 frames per second, and away you go. And if they all have SDI outputs, you're not using any of these things to convert from HDMI to SDI or to scale or to change frame rates. But these tools are available and they allow us to use all of this other equipment with this feature, which is fantastic. So we've got our 4 sources here, and as we're switching to each one of those, and we're not recording right now, we're seeing that change here for the program out. That would be great if you were pushing to a large monitor and let's say, for instance, you had a spillover room and you wanted people to see that program out. You could put a large projector with a screen there and have that, or you could be pushing it to somebody else who's on the crew. And if I go over here to the cogwheel, this is really where we get into some of the options that we have as we are interacting with this. So first and foremost, switch width. By default, your one tap quick cut. We can press that again and we can do 2 tap cuts, which are either quick cuts or they are dissolves. And I'll show you how that works in a minute. We also have our digital audio source, which we can choose basically here. We can have none. We can have follow video, which means as I am pressing on each of these sources, we are switching to the audio that is coming from each one of those sources. We can choose which one it is. In this case, my main audio is coming from a camera and that's where I want it to stay. So I'm just switching picture when I go to the other ones, but if I wanted that audio to come from one of the other ones, I could. And then if you're using the analog in on either the Sumo 19 or on the Shogun 7, you can actually record that as well. That's your 5th audio. And then you can go to audio and you can see that there are tons of different audio options. I don't have anything plugged into there. So when we're looking at our audio here, we can see this is my A camera. And then I have scratch audio on B and C. And then our laptop computer has no audio right now because we're not playing out any audio from the device. And this would be that 5th channel of audio if we were bringing it in. You can embed that analog audio, and then there are additional audio options that you can look into when you're recording as well. So let me just go ahead and step out of there so you can see, and then back into here for these options. Let's go ahead and set this to one tap quick cut first so I can explain how that's working now that we have everything set up. Couple more things. Make sure that your sources are armed for recording. So you can see here that by default they were. They'll have red around them. And what we then do is also decide whether or not we want to record a program stream as well. What does that mean? Well, it's going to record each one of your individual sources in whatever format you've chosen. In this case, we're choosing ProRes HQ. And then on top of that, when you have programs selected, it's also going to record a separate program stream. So now the fun, we get to actually use this feature. So armed for recording, we're going to use the audio from A camera. I'm going to go ahead and program out from my A camera, which is going to be the first thing that's recorded when I press record. And again, we have our program out, which will be recorded as well. Drive is formatted. It has to be approved and fast enough. We're all good with that. I have a fast drive inside of here. So let's go ahead and press record. Now, obviously, if I was doing a real multicam shoot when I was using this feature on either of these devices, probably be a technical director or director. We'd have comm systems with camera operators who are changing their composition and their framing based on what the director wants. And then we would be switching to these different sources. In this case, we're talking about this feature. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over here to our second source. And then I want to talk a little bit about these products. So let's go ahead and switch over to here. These are quick cuts the way I have it set up. So we've got this Connect Convert. This thing is amazing here in terms of what its functionality is. And then what I want to do is, and we'd have somebody doing this, I'll queue up my actual presentation over here and start to play that. And I'll switch over there just so we can see a few of these different clips. And then once I've shown what I want to show, I'll switch back over here to my A camera or my first source, and we can go ahead and stop recording. Now, as soon as we're done with that, and I'm just going to go ahead and reset my presentation, I'm going to go into play on the device, and we are going to access the files. So I'm going to double click here or double tap. We'll see each of our isolated recordings from our different sources. And we will also, because I chose it, have a program stream. So let's just go ahead and play that back. And in the beginning, I'm talking to camera and I'm going over my whole spiel about stuff. So we're not seeing any cuts yet, but you'll see that when I actually turn to the monitor and I say, I'm going to start to talk about this whole feature inside of the monitor, that we are in fact going to change our program stream and our cut. So here we are, and hey, check this out. This is pretty cool. I'm talking about this, and boom, there we are, and we're taking a look at our second source, which is our B camera. I want to talk a little bit about this tabletop stuff. I click over to there, you see that. I'm picking up the product, I'm showing you that. Oh, check this thing out, it's amazing. I can't believe what it can do. And then I'm going to go ahead and queue up my next slide and my video for that. And then I'm going to tap on the screen, which obviously you can't see here, but we're going to go ahead and cut to that. And now we're taking a look at that clip. And again, this would be very typical for a multicam situation. Now let me go ahead here and I'll stop and go back to record, and it'll bring me back into the place where I can actually choose all of these functions again. Go over here to the cogwheel. We're going to change this switch width to two tap cuts and dissolves. Let me show you how this works. If I have this set to auto, I can actually set a certain amount of time that cut is going to happen. If I set it to 0 seconds and 0 frames, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on another source, and then when I tap again is when it's going to cut. Let's actually do that really quickly. I'm just going to go ahead and show you what happens there. I'm going to go ahead and record, and here I am on A. I'm going to go ahead and tap once on B, and you'll see that my program stream does not change when I do that. But when I tap it again, it's going to go ahead and cut to that. So these are still straight cuts, but I have to tap twice to get them. So there you go, that's the way that works. Then we're going to go back in here. I'm going to go ahead and choose auto, and I'm going to do a 1 second dissolve. Here's the thing, this is XML data. So this is going to get brought into, in this case, Final Cut Pro 10, and it will be in your timeline for your program stream as a 1 second dissolve. You won't see that here, it'll just read as a straight cut. But if I just go ahead here, and let's go back to A and press record, I'll press this once. You'll see that it's showing me that I'm going to have a dissolve that's going to be 1 second. I'll tap on this and it will change to that, and then I will have that 1 second dissolve in post-production. And then I'll go ahead and tap again over here and there'll be a 1 second dissolve right there. Last thing to show you, which is the manual dissolve. And if I go in here and I press record, when I tap on another source here, you'll see that it says manual, has not switched my program stream yet. And depending on how fast or slow I drag that slider, that will basically be the length of the dissolve in post-production. I can of course change that in post in my timeline in Final Cut Pro 10, but if I wanted a very slow dissolve, I would go like this. And when I let go, that's when it's going to go ahead and switch. I'll go over here to my second source here, and I'll do a faster, and you'll see That's a faster dissolve. But for most of the situations where I'm gonna be using this feature, I'm either gonna be using the one tap quick cut or I'm gonna be using the two tap cuts either at 0 seconds, which is just gonna be straight cuts, or I'm gonna use maybe a 1 second auto dissolve, which will show up inside of my timeline. Okay, so that is the base functionality of how this all works. Now I just wanna show you some of the differences in terms of how you get to those things here in the Shogun 7. All right, we've offloaded our footage from the Sumo 19. We have a fresh drive in the Shogun 7, and we have now fed all four of our sources, the three cameras and the laptop, into the Shogun 7. Firmware version 10.4, that's what we're running today. And we have an HDMI out, could be SDI out as well, into the Sumo 19. This is now our program. So we can see that as we switch between our different sources. So where is all the stuff here? Well, I'm already in multi-stream. Let me show you how to get there. Up here in the top left, we can see input and source for SDIs. We'll click input here and we have our choices. It's not called multi-stream. It says switching 4x3G SDI, and we click on confirm, which we're already in, and you can see our display. So what about all of those other features? Those are up here under record, under switcher, and you'll see them right here. And I wanna make sure that program is armed for recording, so I get that in my recording. Audio, let's go ahead and make sure that I'm choosing my first input, which is a camera, and then I can cycle through here and decide how I want my cuts. I'm gonna do one touch hard cut, no cue. Step out of here, and I am ready to go. Choose camera A. And I'm going to go ahead and press record. And here we are, and we're talking about all of these cool features with this product. So what I'm going to do is click over here and show you all of this, and you can see the program stream is changing. Now I want to talk about all of this cool stuff that we're using to help it all work with different cameras and devices. That's right here. And I'm going to go ahead and queue up, and again, it would be somebody else doing this video, and I'm going to switch over to the video, and that's going to start to play. Make sure that my clips play out the way I want them to, and then I'm gonna go ahead and switch back to A, and I am ready to go and stop recording. And then we go in, make sure everything's written there. It's gonna create that folder structure again, and then I'm gonna go ahead and press play and go over to this folder icon, and that will bring up all of the different recordings. Again, those are all of the isolated recordings that you had. And then we have our final program recording here, and it's actually going to go ahead and start to play that back. And you can see that when I go ahead and press on there, we have our switching. These are the hard cuts. Of course, if they were dissolves, that would be XML that would be carried over to Final Cut Pro 10. And then you could use another program to convert that XML if you needed to for a different solution. And that is basically the way it works. So there you have it. That's the latest firmware for the Sumo 19 and the Shogun 7 that give you quad HD, live switching, and 5-channel recording. Awesome stuff. Hopefully you learned something. That's always my goal with these videos. And thanks for watching.